Hi folks, just gonna have a really quick demonstration of fiddleware subtitles, and it's a web application that makes it really easy to build subtitles or caption files for your various videos. Now to get started, I'm just gonna drag a video in here to the new project area. It'll load up the video there and it'll give it a name automatically. You can change that if you'd like, and I'm gonna hit create new project. So this opens up the main work view area. At the top, you can see the timeline. And this basically allows you to fast forward or rewind videos. And as you add captions, they'll actually appear on here. This is the main video area. And you can either choose to alter the playback rate, so you can slow it down if you'd like. You can control the playback. You can either play or pause it, fast forward or rewind, or you can set the looping rate, or you can turn off looping entirely. I find looping very useful for captioning, and so it's set on by default. And I'll show you how it works in a second here. Now there's also the caption area itself, and this is where all of your captions will appear once you start entering them. There's an insert caption button that will insert a caption at the time you are at in the timeline. And there are various hints. Now these are basically just shortcuts for various common tasks that you'll probably perform, like lengthening or shortening a caption. You can import a caption file. So you can import an SRT file from a pre-existing project and it'll load it up into here. And you can also export your project. So this is what you'll do once you're done captioning. You'll hit export, it'll download an SRT file for you, and you can use that to play back alongside your videos. So I'm just gonna get started here and start captioning. So you can see here that it's entered a caption onto the timeline, it's playing, and it's looping for 5 seconds. It's also entered a caption text node for us right here, and we can start entering text. But of course, there's no actual audio to transcribe here, so I'm just going to hit return, and it'll skip us to the next caption and delete the previous one. So whenever you hit return on an empty caption, it will create a new caption after it and delete the previous empty caption. This one right here, I'll probably actually want to start to create a new caption.
So I'm going to do the same thing. Hit enter.
Turn down the volume a little bit. Now, it would be nice if this caption started a little bit earlier. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Command U. Like it says to do here. Command U. Decrement caption start time. I'm going to do that until I feel like it starts at the appropriate time. Sorry.
Good evening. What you're about to witness is an Good evening.
I feel like that's pretty good. You can also use this dragger here to alter the start and time of the caption.
Good evening. What you're about to witness is an unrehearsed, uncensored interview on the issue of birth control. Good evening. What you're about to witness is an unrehearsed, uncensored interview on the issue of birth control. Good evening. What you're about to witness is an unrehearsed, uncensored interview on the issue of birth control. Good evening. What you're about to witness is...
And then you hit enter when you're done your caption, and then jump to the next one. And we'll start looping for the next 5 seconds of the video. Now, you can see here that it's added the caption to the timeline. And just a few details about these captions is that their width represents their time span. So if you had a really long caption in terms of duration, it would be really wide on the timeline. A really short one is really skinny. And the height, and I think this is pretty important, represents the words per minute. So if you have a really tall caption, that means you have to read it quite fast in order to read it, all of it, before it disappears. If you have a really short one, it means that there's very little read and you have lots of time to do it. Now the colors act as a bit of a warning. So if you have an orange caption like this one here, it means that it's kind of borderline on being too many words per minute. If you have a red caption, and I'll just try entering a bunch of gobbledygook here. Now this would be way too much to read in that duration. You can see it's entered a red caption for me. Now that means I probably want to change it. It's probably too many words per minute. But you can be the judge of it. It's just a passive warning. It's not going to prevent you from exporting your subtitle files or anything like that. So one of the great things about this, I think, is that all of these are synchronized. So if you click on the caption here, it'll focus your caption right here. And if I start playback, it'll start looping those 5 seconds. If I click this caption, it fast forwards to that, focuses on this caption, and starts looping. If I click on this caption, it re-syncs the video to those 5 seconds that correspond with this caption. That's just a really easy way to keep everything sort of in sync and keep everything organized. Now, when you're all done, it's quite easy to just export your caption file. What you do, you just hit export, and it downloads an SRT file to your downloads folder. Now, if you're using Firefox, I believe that it will open the caption in a new window, so it won't actually download the file because of constraints with the browser. But if you're using Internet Explorer 10 or Chrome, it should just download it to your downloads folder. And then you can use this file like you would any other SRT file. You can upload it to YouTube, or you can load it up alongside your videos in Windows Media Player, QuickTime, or VLC. So those are the real basics of fiddleware subtitles, and I hope you find it useful.